easily we can remember it like this. If, see here, we can see two velocities are there, final velocity and initial velocity. If initial velocity is zero, then acceleration, okay? And if final velocity is zero, then it is called deacceleration, okay? So if final velocity is zero, deacceleration. If initial velocity is zero, acceleration. Acceleration means the speed increases. Deacceleration means the speed decreases. So now we'll try to understand this now with the help of an example problem. So let's say a car is starting from rest, okay, attains a velocity of 30 meter per second. In how much time? It took only 20 seconds for the car to attain a speed of 30 meter per second. Initially, what was the speed of a car? A car is starting from rest. So here the car was at rest, it was stationary, it was not moving. So this means initially the velocity of the car was zero meter per second. And then in 20 seconds, when someone sat inside the car and started running it, within 20 seconds, the speed has reached to 30 meter per second. Okay, then the question says, find or calculate how much is the acceleration of the car. So depending on acceleration, we can see if the car has very high acceleration, it will take less time to reach to this speed. Okay, but right now we'll solve this question. So first of all, what is given in the question that we should find out? So we saw that a car is starting from rest. So initial velocity is how much? Zero. Then in 20 seconds, in how much time? 20 seconds, it attains a velocity of 30 meter per second. So this is the final velocity, second position of the car. So final velocity of a car is how much? 10 meter per second. Oh, very, very sorry. This should be actually 30 meter per second. So please do the correction. Final velocity of the car is how much? 30 meter per second. This should be 30. And time is how much? 20 seconds it took. So initially the car was at rest, it was not moving. Then in 20 seconds, its speed increased to 30 meter per second. Okay, then we have to find what was the acceleration of a car. And then we know that acceleration is what? Final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. Okay, and acceleration is also written as small a, remember. So final velocity is how much? Final velocity of a car is 30. I told you, if initial velocity is zero, that means the speed is increasing. There is acceleration. Okay, so final velocity is 30, initial velocity is zero, and time is how much? 20 seconds. So this will become 30 divided by 20, and SI unit of acceleration is meter divided by second square. Okay. So 30 divided by 20, 0 cancel, 3 by 2, it will be 1.5 meter per second squared. So if the acceleration of a car is 1.5 meter per second square, it takes 20 seconds to increase the speed of a car to 30 meter per second. If the acceleration of the car will be more than 1.5, for example, if the acceleration is 2 or maybe 3 or 5 meter per second square, then it will take only 5 seconds to reach to a speed of 30 meter per second. Okay, so everyone should remember and pay very, very good attention here. If the initial velocity is 0, that means the car is accelerating. Okay, and if acceleration is less, that means it will take more time to reach to certain speed. If the acceleration of a car is more, that means it will take less time to reach to a certain speed. Very, very important. Then let's say we'll go for a second question to understand what is deacceleration. Here a bus is traveling very fast, okay, and then it was brought to rest by applying brake. Maybe the bus is about to reach the signal, traffic signal, so the driver has applied brake to stop the car at the traffic signal. Otherwise, the traffic police person will challenge him. Okay, he will put a lot of bill to break the signal. No one should break the signal. Okay, everyone should try to stop at red signal. Okay, so a bus which is running very very fast, it was brought to rest. Okay, so initially the bus was running very very fast, that means it was having some speed. When we applied a brake, the speed was maximum, and then it should it is coming to rest, that means before reaching the signal and before the zebra line crossing, the bus halted, it came to rest. So final velocity is how much here? Zero. Now I told you, whenever the final velocity is zero, the speed is decreasing. You're getting me? So by applying brakes, in how much time? It took him 10 seconds. If the acceleration of the car, it should be deceleration. Okay, so if the acceleration of the car is 5 meter per second square. Acha, if this is deceleration, then why we are calling it acceleration? Because the value here is not given in minus. So when there is only value, we write acceleration. If the acceleration of the car is 5 meter per second square, find its initial velocity. Now nobody knows what was the initially when we applied a brake, how fast that vehicle was running. That is very very important. So first step, what we have to do is we have to read the question and find out what is given in the question. Very very important. So first thing, we know final velocity is zero because the vehicle or the bus, what we have here, bus, the bus was brought to rest just before the signal, before the zebra crossing. That means the velocity of the bus is how much? Zero. Okay, by applying brake we stopped the bus, so 0 meter per second. Fine. Then how much time it took for the bus to come to rest or halt? It took the bus 10 seconds. When we applied a brake, after applying brake and after 10 seconds of applying the brake, the bus has stopped. The acceleration of the bus was 5. So time taken is 10 seconds and acceleration is, here you can see deceleration, that means the value should be in minus. So deceleration of the bus is minus 5 seconds square. Now we have to find what is the initial velocity. Very tricky. Everyone has to pay attention and remember. Any doubt, you can call me anytime. Okay. So what we have to find? Initial velocity. What do we know? So first of all, we know that acceleration of a vehicle is what? Final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. That is what we know. So acceleration equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. Okay, but we don't want acceleration, we want initial velocity u. So what we should do? We should do cross multiplication. When we multiply this t in the denominator with a, so this will become a into t is equals to v minus u. Still we want only u on the left hand side. So let's say first make positive everything. So let's say u goes to the other side and it becomes plus u plus 8. So v is equals to u plus 8. V is final velocity, u is initial velocity, a is the acceleration, deceleration actually, and t is the time. Okay, so don't get confused here why it is not minus a, because a has a value of minus 5 and this is just mathematical expression. Okay, so we have to take u to the left hand side, so it will become like this. U is equals to v minus 8. Why we are taking u to the left hand side? Because v is known to us, a is known to us, and t is also known to us. So we can easily calculate what is the final velocity. 0, because the bus stopped. So final velocity. And how much is deceleration? Minus of 5. Time it took is 10 seconds. Right? So 5 tens are 50. It will become minus 50. Minus 50, and outside there will be a minus sign. So minus minus plus. The answer is 50 meter per second. So that means the bus was initially traveling at a speed of 50 meter per second when the driver applied a brake. When the driver applied a brake, the speed of the bus was 50 meter per second, right? And then it took for the bus to stop, for the bus to stop, it took 10 seconds. by applying the brake. 10 seconds it took to stop the bus. And what was the acceleration? It was minus 5 meter per second square. Deceleration because the bus is stopping. Fine. So if you will see here, I told you initially also, if u is 0, the speed should increase. That is called acceleration. If any question you find v is equals to 0, then that is called deceleration. Here you can see in deceleration, u is greater than v. Fine. So just by looking, reading the question, we can find out whether the bus is accelerating or whether the bus is deaccelerating. So thank you very much. Have a good day. Any doubt, you can call me anytime. That's all for today's class.